warning, this podcast contains spoilers.
And sand.
It's everywhere.
It's irritating.
Hello everyone and welcome to the As Seen on TV podcast for Star Wars Rebels Season 3, Episodes 12 and 13, Ghosts of Geonosis. I'm your host Cleo, and with me I have John and Sam.
Hello.
Hi guys.
I forgot what Geonosians were.
So did I. I was like, wait, they're bugs, hold on. And then he popped out and I'm like, ah, there he is. Okay.
Right.
Click clack.
He was adorable.
Right now. That's not good. Oh, guy.
And I think it was really genius that they gave us, you know, a character we couldn't understand. Because they got to keep a lot of it in the dark. And a lot of it was just what they could figure out.
Mm-hmm.
And I was trying to figure out, was he drawing the Death Star? Because when, as soon
absolutely
as he,
was.
As soon as he drew it, I'm like, ah, there's the Death Star. And then
that was the Death Star.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
and they're like,
they
oh, the canisters
not...
must be what he was drawing. And I was like,
well,
oh.
Because
no, guys,
if you remember,
no.
The end of episode 3, they're building the Death Star at Geonosis.
Mm.
Yeah.
And that's what that shield generator
like,
was for.
Yep. He's okay. like the guy who's like the king or whatever. Sorry if I'm like being specious, but he's like walking away. He's like, if they find out what we're building, he's got the little hologram of it. And he's like walking away with his walker at the end. Yes. So he's like, so, yes.
Mm-hmm. And then the deal was, is that basically the Geonosians had the basic design for the Death Star, but they couldn't figure out the firing mechanism. And that's where Rey's dad kind of steps in.
You mean Jin's dad?
Jin's dad.
Galen or so?
we don't know. Listen, who Rey's dad is.
I'm exhausted. Yeah, we do. It's, okay. It's Chopper.
Exactly.
Confirmed. You're welcome. Yeah, so that's basically like why. And then they moved it from Geonosis because, well, weirdly enough, because Saul got too close to figuring it out. So
I mean,
they were like, you know what?
Let's move that. So wait.
It goes somewhere else.
The shield generator was supposed to be mounted on the Death Star? Was that the deal?
No. No, it's protecting it from the planet. Remember, like, in episode 6, when why they went to Endor in the first place to destroy the shield generator that's protecting the second Death Star? It's projecting the shield from the planet to the Death Star. Because they didn't have time to finish the shielding on the Death Star itself, so...
Oh.
They had to do it remotely.
Okay. Because that's... At the end, I was sort of like, wait, what was the shield generator doing? Because they got down to the planet with no problem, and...
Yeah. But that was the only reason, just to keep it safe while it was being built. And to help it being built, so shift it and float away, you know...
Yeah.
Kind of helps when you're in space.
Mm-hmm.
So, there's that too. But, yeah, that's why all that was there.
Okay. Cool.
I think that covers everything. Right?
Yeah. So, not only did we got Saw Gerrera in this episode, we also got a small cameo of Senator Bail Organa in the beginning.
Yeah.
And I was like, cool. I wonder if this guy is the actor from the movies too. And I looked it up. It's actually Phil Lamar, the comedian. So that shocked me. Apparently he's been doing the voice for Bail this whole season. As long as he's been in Rebels. So I was like, that's funny. I like that. And he does such a good job too, because I actually thought it was the actor from the movies.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, that was Forrest Whitaker.
Yes.
Okay, I figured. I was like, his voice is pretty distinct, but I didn't get, like, I tried several times to pause the credits, and I couldn't do it.
He's very breathy when he speaks.
Yeah, but I was like, that sounds like him. I feel like they would have gotten him to do it and make sense with all.
Well, yeah, and considering I just watched the Rebels Recon, they were explaining, like, because like they rewrote Saw in Rogue One so many times, like they had to kind of redo this episode a few times to like kind of get their stuff together before they like asked Forrest Whitaker to be like, "Hey, can you come on our children's show?"
Yeah.
I know you've like won some Oscars or whatever, and you're a serious actor, but.
But could you please do our children's show?
We got a prepubescent kid with a glow stick over here who really wants you on the show. So,
do you mind? Is that okay? Is that cool? Can we do that, please?
Yeah,
Mister Sir. Yeah. So, because and the funny thing was like, and I just realized it now, is that Forrest Whitaker in the original like trailers for Rogue One had no hair, so he was probably closer to what we saw in this episode than what we saw in the actual movie, because he's got like that big floof.
Yeah.
Hair going
oh,
up.
I didn't.
No, that's the thing though too. When he comes to find Jin when she's a young girl, he does not have the
oh,
hair.
Oh, right.
So...
Yeah. That's right.
But that's really... where I thought actually the timing almost didn't work out. So I was like a little bit concerned, but I was like, because 15 years is supposed to have passed. She says as much. So I was like, oh gosh, we must be further into this at this point, or that went on longer than I thought it did before we got to the point, which you know.
We're still like a few years out from Rogue One from the show right now.
Two or three years.
I think when it started, it was supposed to be like 5 years out. So yeah.
Okay, so like two, yeah.
And every season's a year. So. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's.
Well, that's why. Like, is Jin already hidden somewhere as like a near adult then? Because otherwise, the timing doesn't quite work out.
Well,
right.
I think it's. This seems like it's after she's grown up. She, in the movie, says, and we're not going to spoil, like, we're not going to do big spoils. We're just going to talk about, like, stuff that has to do with this episode. So this has to do with this episode. Great. Yeah. She hadn't seen
really,
him for
have you
years.
Not seen Rogue One yet? You're watching the fucking cartoon show and you haven't... Never mind. That's your fault.
She said she hadn't seen him for years.
Your priorities.
When she, right. She's telling Cassian and Mon Mothma, is that her name?
Mothma.
She's telling them she hadn't seen him for years.
Yeah, but we don't
so
have any of
six
that could just
or be a few. 5 years. She said she hadn't seen him in. So at this point, I think he's already left her.
Yeah.
And she's doing whatever she's doing before. The Rebellion picks her up for the mission in Rogue One.
Dang, he has some last couple of rough years with that hair, though, bro.
Not just the hair!
Because the same in the beginning. Like, the way they have him in the episode of Rebels is pretty much the same as at the very beginning of Rogue One.
Yeah.
So, spoiler. Sorry, yeah. Hairdo spoiler.
It's not just it's not just the hair. He doesn't have a breather. His voice isn't nearly as rough.
Yeah.
He doesn't have the limp.
There's all that stuff.
Yeah. Wait,
all
no,
of that.
He doesn't have fucking robot legs.
Yeah,
yeah.
So,
well, which is
limp.
Why he's limping. Which is why he's limping.
He went through some stuff right there. Because I was like, I thought that they were trying to make him like a parallel to Vader with all that stuff, but I was like, anyway, we're getting away from the point. Sorry, spoilers!
No. But no, that's how he appears in the... He's in the... That scene's in the trailer. A bit of that
yeah,
scene's in
yeah.
the trailer where we see him with the breather and every... All of the...
Okay.
All of the stuff. And he has the limp. He limps towards Jin in the trailer, so... That's not really his
yeah.
But,
yeah.
But the next couple of years are going to be bad for him. I hope we actually get to see it.
Yeah. Like, real bad.
Mm-hmm. Before this episode, I went back. I finally did it. All those times we said we were going to go back and watch Clone Wars, I actually did it this time. I went back and I watched the arc with Saw and Onderon, which I think the planet was. Yeah. Forgot how good that four episode arc was.
It's good.
It is so good.
It's very good.
Yeah. And that's where we meet his sister, Steela. Who
She's
led
a badass.
She really was a badass. She was a kick-ass sniper.
Yeah.
And she was a great leader.
Mm-hmm.
And the Saw that we see in Clone Wars and the Saw that we see in Rogue One, this Saw is, like, right in the middle. And I was like, wow, they did a really good job of taking the old Saw and the old, beat-up Saw and, like, the young Saw and putting him right in the middle. Because the chuckles that he does in these episodes, remind me of Clone Wars. But it's like a gruff chuckle. I don't know. I thought they did a really good job.
Well, also, he, you know, like, we'll probably get into it more, but just, like, you know, he's being, like, they don't, you know, that he has this reputation of being a little too extreme, and they get to see it firsthand with what he's trying to do with Click Clack and things like that. And in the end, though, he comes to his senses, and I don't know that that version of him, like, that we see in Rogue One would do that. At that point, he's just kind of a crazy old man, which that, you know, okay, fine. So, and he's just, like, too, like, at that point, he's just super, super paranoid, and maybe not extremist anymore, because he just doesn't have it within him anymore, but he's just a crazy old person who's extremely paranoid. But for here, it's, he still kind of comes to his senses, so especially when, like, you know, Rex is, like, I was, like, wait, I was, like, who is he gonna listen to but Rex? So I really like that he got in his face, and he said, yes, you do care. I was, like, yeah, listen to him.
Yeah.
So, like, come on.
Yeah, but we really see just how kind of desperate he is to win this war.
Mm-hmm.
He's seen this war fail already with the separatists. Oh my gosh, I'm going back and watching Clone Wars. I'm starting to get the terminologies confused again because it's like almost the same, just different names, like. You know, the separatists.
Well, I was gonna say the separatists ultimately become the Empire. Like,
yeah,
it's kind of the same thing. You know, they only infiltrate from the inside. Turn of the Empire is not the same thing.
Well, confused.
I mean, he did make a dig at the Jedi. You know.
He did.
Yeah, your tactics didn't work. We lost already.
Right. So, you know.
Mm-hmm. Excuse me, sir. Two Jedi trained you. Whatever.
Also, well, we hit the bell for the Kanan's blind joke for the episode, too. That was good.
Oh, yeah.
I missed that.
He was like, watch your step, Master Jedi, when they were walking towards the cliff.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Wait, well, oh, okay. My God. Kanan gave me such a force hard-on right there. I was like, oh, my God, he can hold up this whole thing for that long. That's really great.
Not only that.
Although that was very impressive. Dude. I was like, whoa, somebody's been practicing
here. He throws Ezra. He holds up the bridge, he does a long jump, and then they diss him and say he's no Skywalker. I'm like, shut your mouth, Rex. I love you. Shut your mouth.
Are you crazy?
That was hilarious because they're like, they say it under their breath, and he's like, I heard that.
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
Now, granted, I don't think he could take Anakin on his best day.
No.
No, but he could mess him up.
Oh god.
Just throwing
it
out there.
I honestly would love to see like a young Anakin fight this Kanan. I think that would be a very interesting fight.
Oh, this Kanan would kick his ass because he's too arrogant.
Yeah, probably.
I mean, yeah. Definitely. But like,
I would like to see Ahsoka now with a younger Anakin. I'd be like, yeah, I want to see that.
No, that wouldn't be a fight. that wouldn't be a fight. She would just put him down.
Stomp him, yeah.
I mean, you have to realize, like, Anakin, well, Vader, is a lot physically stronger just because he's a friggin' robot. So, like, just physically... Yeah, like, he's very heavy and very strong because he's a robot, so it helps. He's slower, but, you know, you can take a blaster shot to the face and not really care.
Yeah, be like, that's...
So, you know, yeah.
Or, you know, he'll just hold out his hand and stop it, like, right before he even gets to him. It's fine. He's like, oh, that? Okay, nice try.
Yeah, but anyway, Kanan's awesome, and my jaw hit the floor when he did that.
Oh,
I was going... I was like, yeah, no, that was an amazing, I was like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, this is so cool.
Yeah, and when he was holding the bridge, I'm like, Kanan, you could have taken a small piece and just, like, floated them across, but it's like, I'll let you go.
look at how strong I am.
Yeah. Yeah.
Exactly. Oh, let him have it.
Yeah.
And then they're kind of being like, la, la, like, I get it, it's like a little precarious, but like, come on, guys, hurry up, let's go, come on.
Well, think about it. Think about it this way. You can't go too fast or Kanan loses the balance. And they can't go too fast or they lose the balance. So they do have to creep
be a little stuff ginger keep, about yeah, it. All right, fine.
To keep everything floating properly.
Right.
So, yeah. This episode, I think, is the episode I've been... these two episodes. It's what I've been waiting for a while with the show. It showcased every single character doing the badass stuff they always do, you know, that they're known for. Because it, you know, Sabine fucked up those troopers, you know, Kanan did his thing, Ezra did the negotiating with the Geonosian, Zeb, not only did Zeb, you know, was shooting a bunch, but he, what I thought was hilarious was he was the one who asked the question. He's like, so, is nobody gonna ask why is there this fully operational shield generator on this deserted planet? And then Sabine's like, oh yeah, that's a good question. And then obviously Hera did the ship mommy stuff. So everybody shined.
She did some ace piloting and some good commanding there. Some good general stuff right there.
And generally worrying about Kanan.
Yes.
Yes. Which is
adorable. Zeb, I'm going to make you run this thing over there just to make sure Kanan's okay.
Yeah.
Like, oh, okay.
My sweet flying baby can't die.
Yeah.
I liked when they had Sabine going out on her jetpack. They're like, Ezra's like, oh, they're gonna have a problem.
I want one of those. I know.
I want one of those. I know.
Everybody does.
She kicked ass, man.
Well, that was cool, too. What did they call those guys? Did they call them rocket troopers? I was like, what?
Yeah.
I think so.
I was like, you know, what?
It's really funny, because I know I always talk about the board games and stuff, but, like, the new expansion for Imperial Assault came out, and Jet Troopers are in it, and I was like, oh.
There you are.
Decent accidental marketing.
Yeah. Or is it an accident?
I mean...
I was going to say, is it an accident?
It's totally...
I was like, we have scout troopers, death troopers, flame troopers, storm troopers, snow troopers.
Shore troopers.
Shore troopers. The shore troopers, yeah.
The shore troopers.
You get to wear the easy breezy pants.
They really
I like their
cool.
helmets. It's yeah. cool.
They're the easiest ones to cosplay, by the way.
Oh, really?
Because you don't have to worry about the top half. The bottom half is khakis and boots.
Yeah.
It's really easy. Anyway, yeah, so I think this is, we haven't seen Jet Troopers, like, since the video games, so
yeah.
I don't think they've ever been in anything, I mean, unless you really count the Mandalorians, but they're not, it's not the same thing.
No,
so,
it's not.
You know,
those are Imperial Super Commandos.
Right.
So those are.
And, alright, to play devil's advocate very briefly, and I don't believe this, but something I saw floating around on the internet is people were upset at how OP Sabine is. Right, so she, like, took out 6 troopers by herself, right?
Yeah.
But, and to a degree, I get that, but, and everyone's like, oh, it's because it's a kid show and she's the main character. It's like, no, not really, because you have to realize they hardly train half of these stormtroopers.
Yeah.
Like, stormtroopers are not elite fighters. They're mostly terrible because they don't have time to train them. They just need numbers to control planets. It's not like, you know, they were like a main fighting force. They're not Vader. They're not like part of Vader's retinue, who he takes like the best of the best. That's why, you know, his troop is called Vader's Finest. So, you know, to the people who may be thinking like, why are they so good at stuff? It's like, because stormtroopers are actually not that well trained. They're not great soldiers.
They're kind of terrible, and they miss a lot. Like, they don't fucking heads for nothing.
And not just, like, in a joking way. Like literally, they give them a gun, they slap them in crappy armor that they hardly know how to work, and are like, okay, go.
You don't have to look farther than the droids. They made the droids terrible on purpose, because they didn't want to put any extra effort into them.
The same,
I mean, this is the same regime we're carrying it over from the Separatists to the Empire. So they've got the same mindset.
Yeah,
and,
so...
Rex, in one of his first episodes, season 2, he got shot, and he's like, oh god, this is not you know, this is not the clone armor, this is really shitty, you know, so not only are they not trained, they've got shitty armor.
Got crappy equipment, yeah. I mean, their blasters aren't spectacular, you know, like, they just don't, you know, they don't invest. I mean, really, the only time they've ever really invested in anything is, like, honestly, the First Order. And that's 30 years from now.
I was gonna say, definitely a difference between the Empire and the First Order, for sure.
Yeah.
Doesn't seem to be, there is.
Because they decided to put, like, you know these TIE fighter things? Maybe we should put a shield on them.
Yeah.
Just a thought.
Just a thought.
Just a thought.
It can hold up a little
better.
Also,
we have a slight inclination that perhaps that these troops are actually trained well. We don't really know that for a fact.
Well, yeah, there is, but...
There's just a little slight nod to it. Mm-hmm. We don't know how much that carries over, but as far as we know, as far as General Hux is concerned, you know.
I mean, like, any stormtrooper you see with an orange shoulder pad, they're a commander, or at least a captain.
Yeah, they're commander or captain.
So, like, they're probably competent, but assume that these are basically just, like, guys, you know, modified farmers with pitchforks.
Mm-hmm. So exactly. And they say things like, look, sir, droids!
Do we shoot them, boss?
Oh, my God. And as much as I say I hate the battle droids, hearing them go, what's that, was just so fucking funny.
I was gonna say, I'll always love hearing, Roger, Roger. I'm never gonna get tired of that.
Because, like, they're trying to ambush Kanan and Rex and Ezra, and then just in 5 seconds, Saw takes every one of them out, including the destroyer. And it was just like, oh. But then...
They're like, uh-oh.
Then again, droids and destroyers, Saw was literally trained to stop them really quickly. So he was basically fighting the perfect target for him.
Right. I mean, and to be fair, Kanan and Ezra could have just force pushed the thing and stabbed it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you see, in the Clone Wars episodes with Saw, they did the technique of rolling the grenade really slowly under the floor. And as soon as the destroyer popped up, I was like, are we going to get that? And then he just, like, immediately blows them all up. And I guess, well, you know, not quite the
same,
but
still.
Maybe
not, but, I mean,
effective.
He definitely mastered some kind of, like, you know, bomb technique there. Just...
Well, like, it's because there's, like, I know in Star Wars there's two kinds of shields. There's, like, ray shields and particle shields. Mm-hmm. It's like the particle shields block lasers and ray shields block project, like, actual physical objects. So I'm assuming the destroyer droids have both?
Yes. The key was you could get a, like, like, if you threw a grenade at them fast in the air,
it would bounce.
It would bounce
yeah.
off. The only way to get a grenade past their shields is to roll it really slowly, and it would just go under.
Which makes sense, because the ray wouldn't have, you know, the ray wouldn't catch it.
It would think
stop
it was
it.
A rock.
Yeah. Well, and that's the funny thing. So, like, what's it called? When the Imperial Artigans, the light cruiser, shows up?
Yeah.
And, you know, they had a little bombing run, which is cute. And
cute.
And then they were really stupid and flew above the ghost. And the ghost, like once shot it with proton torpedoes.
Oh, yeah. As soon
guess
as
who
she
didn't
said
turn
proton
on their
torpedoes.
Fucking, well, guess who didn't turn on their fucking ray shield? That would be the Artigans, because they were like, oh, it doesn't have proton torpedoes.
Yeah.
Like, that, we'll stop the lasers, boss. That didn't work out, so that's why you turn on both, kids.
Oh my god, because the torpedoes hit and, like, blew the ship in fucking half. I was just like, oh.
Well, they're not very heavily, I mean, you look at the size of that thing compared to the ghost, and the ghost is almost the size of it.
Yeah, no, like, I know, but it was just, didn't expect that much.
Well, the ghost can also carry stronger proton torpedoes than, like, an X-Wing could. Because it's got larger ordnance tubes, so it's probably using, like, really high power proton torpedoes. So, it kind of makes sense. But still, that was rad as shit.
Yeah. No. Yeah, Hera was just like, oh, we're gonna fuck them up. It's fine, guys. Sabine's like, they're blocking us. Like, oh, it's fine. Don't worry.
They done you.
Don't worry about it.
They have somebody who's not paying attention. I got it.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Oh, and the lady who was running the Artigans, her name is Brunson, in case you want to know.
Okay. I'm looking at her, and I swear to God, so I'm thinking, I was like, oh, maybe. So I couldn't help it, but, like, reading Lost Stars, like, I was like, is that Sienna? No, and she wouldn't be that stupid neither, so, but it's not.
Oh, yeah. Isn't Sienna, she's a interceptor pilot, isn't she?
Yeah, I mean, but she's pretty high ranking because she was like just climbed the ranks there very quickly. So,
Okay.
But I mean, she was like an intercenter pilot and something else. Yeah. I forgot. But she got promoted very quickly. So.
Okay.
I just thought it'd be cool if they tied that in too, but I was like too much to hope for it. And also, again, in the end, we saw what happens going to blow up the whole ship. I was like, she would never do that. Also, technically, she is a, you know, spoiler for the Lost Stars. She's a good person, so.
Yep. Well, her and Thane have a thing. Thane Tyrell.
Oh, yeah. Well. I know.
Boy, do they have a thing.
If anybody hasn't read that book, go read it. It's real, real good. Claudia Gray wrote it. She's one of the better new Star Wars authors out there. Go read that right now.
Do it. I was going to say. Brunson, John, you said her name was?
Brunson, okay. Yeah.
She had to look at the end when the ship was, like, falling apart. She just goes like this. And I'm like, are we going to see her again? Is she going to get a... another position on another ship. The look she gave was a very, like, I've seen Callus give this look before, you know? Like, we're probably going to see her again.
I'll get you, Gadget, next time.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it looked like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it'd be nice, see her again. Oh, where was I gonna go from that?
Speaking of Agent Callus, I'm a little worried for the guy. I was like, but I'm sure we'll get into that later. I was like,
Especially because I'm pretty sure Thrawn already knows it's him.
Oh yeah, he totally knows.
It's like no way. Oh shit.
I was like, ooh. But I think Callus knows. He knows. I think. I hope. I don't know. But I'm like, ooh. You know, watch your tread carefully, my friend. You're gonna wind up dead very quickly.
In the original story. Thrawn, he was actually undone by an internal spy. So, I think it's kind of funny. They're kind of maybe going the opposite way with this. But.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Anyway, we'll get to that in a sec.
We'll get to that.
We will. What they brought up in this episode, we're going to go back to Saw. was the debate over, like, how war is conducted, and, like, which, you know, what bad stuff, like, makes you the bad guy, basically. And, Saw was treading that line, you know?
Well, no, it's, they said, you know, if you do this, you know better than the Empire. That's a similar theme that they brought up repeatedly in Rogue One as well, actually, so...
Mm-hmm.
The things that they did for the cause, or what they thought they were doing the right thing, and, you know, just kind of taking a step back and really realizing at what cost are you making a decision, and really just because he was being so aggressive about Click Clack, and like, he's like, I don't care, I'm gonna threaten the egg. I was like, whoa, buddy. I was telling, like, Ezra, I was like, I don't like this guy, this is
bad,
she needs to calm down. But it made sense, and I thought they actually played it very well, but finally he, like, kind of came to himself, and I was like, whoa.
And for a bunch of different reasons that makes sense, and even, you know, Kanan is like, after everything that Saw has been through, I kind of understand.
And I like that he explained to Ezra, too, like, you know, like, with people, you know, this rebellion, there's a lot of different people, and they don't all share the same values as us, so.
Yeah.
Yep.
And they're not all going to be fighting for the same reasons.
Right.
Yep.
I mean, and it was funny because I was like, oh man, maybe Saw can turn this thing around. I was like, wait, no, duh. He doubles down on the crazy.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah.
He doesn't get less extreme.
No.
And in fact,
he gets a mind sucking thing.
As I say, that...
No.
Poor Gullet. What is that?
Yeah. No. Rogue One. Go see it. Anyway.
Yeah. Spoilers.
Sort of spoilers.
I mean, hey guys, it was a little weird.
The sequel to Rogue One is. It's A New Hope.
Yes.
Oh man, I can't believe I have to wait till 1977 for the sequel.
To see what happens after Rogue One.
Does time come back around? Does it loop? Is that how that works? Because we have to wait a while.
Then. Yeah. Oh yeah.
It's, you know what? It's a wibbly wobbly timey wimey thing, so it can do that.
Right. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, the one thing I was like a little uneasy about with this episode was like, Saw lost his whole retinue of dudes to Click-Clack's droids, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that's what was implied. And Click-Clack thought that they were Imperials or whatever coming to get him, because apparently they gassed his entire species off the planet, which is terrifying. And basically committed genocide. So I get both sides there. But, like, I sort of felt like it was a little too easy for Saw to be like, for really all of them to be like, well, I mean, you killed a whole rebel troop, but you're cute. Go ahead, me a little hole, little man. You know?
Yeah.
I kind of thought that was a little too easy for them to just kind of let that go. It's like, you're kind of responsible for the lives of five of our men. I don't know. That was my only qualm with this episode.
Well, I think Ezra brought up the counter to that, where you and your men came with guns and probably started shooting at him.
Yeah, I mean, that's true. I guess that's kind of the cost of war.
Also, and it is also a
protect that egg, which is the whole, which is like
his entire
everybody,
race,
basically.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's probably also the mama bear's response to, oh, someone's close to the nest, shoot it.
Kill it. Well, he didn't do it, but the droids did.
Yes. So. Well, he fixed the droids and told the droids to go shoot them.
Well, they are tinkerers, so they're good at that.
Yeah. I like how he just, you know, lifted the rock and, like, climbed down. It's like, you were just a burrower. I love it.
Yeah.
I like all the tunnels. They were walking down the tunnel in the beginning of the first episode, and it's just like, all these tunnels are sealed off. I'm like, trap.
Nothing that simple, guys. This is not, no, you don't want to do this.
Mm-mm.
Well, it's kind of set up like an anthill, just, you know, bigger.
Yeah. Hey, where was all the conveyor belt nonsense and the lava that poured into the cups and stuff? Where did that go? I wanted to see that. Where is the arena with those animals?
He can't maintain all that all by himself.
Poor little Click-Clack.
Yeah. There's only so much one generation can do. Yeah. And it wasn't even just, you know, Saw that was treating him badly. Like, not Rex didn't treat him badly. He just had an offhand remark, like, still ugly. It's like, come on, right to his face, man. He doesn't understand what you're saying, but still.
And they were rude to Chopper as well. Just want to point that out.
Oh, Chopper, very man. Rude to Chopper. Oh, yeah, this is Chopper.
Right, sorry.
That was hilarious. I was like, that's...
Like, what am I, chopped liver?
This is... Sorry, this is Burton. I mean Chopper.
Burton.
And he did a lot of... Chopper was doing a lot of this in the episode, too. Like,
What the... Fuck, man. What? Yeah,
no, he was. It was quite funny.
I didn't do anything today.
I haven't fucked up yet.
It's been at least a half an hour.
Before it's ruined something. I mean,
before I ruined something. It was rude. Come on.
Yeah.
By the way, I love when he runs on his little front wheelie thing and his legs are just kind of flailing in the background. I love the way they animate that. It's so funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is cute. Well, I like that, actually, after Kanan, like, through Ezra, he's like, Chopper, go on. And he, like, does a little thing. I was like, aw, it's so cute.
Yeah. Yeah. So this is, has nothing to do with Star Wars at all, but I was watching this on Disney XD, and there was a trailer. They're remaking DuckTales, guys.
You didn't know that?
I didn't!
Didn't we talk about that at Christmas?
I heard David Tennant was going to be Scrooge McDuck. I'm like,
Whatever.
We talked about a decorating the, while decorating your tree,
and I didn't remember, and I was pleasantly surprised.
Okay.
I'm just excited, so thank you, John.
It's got such a good theme song.
Yeah, it really does.
Yeah, well, we'll have our DuckTales podcast coming soon.
Right after.
That one will probably be a all-at-once sort of a thing.
It's just going to be us high-fiving and going DuckTales.
So yeah, that's the end of
black.
It.
What else do you need to do?
That's it. That's going to be... I sort of now just want to do a joke podcast that's literally just us high-fiving and saying DuckTales. Okay,
I'll
anyway.
Cool, baby.
Oh, Dom is in chat, wants to, did we hear the theory that Darth Maul is actually Boba Fett?
What?
Yeah, no.
Dom.
It's a stupid
take
theory.
Take your horse and ride it home.
So.
Let it go, guys. Let it go. Just let it go.
So. I think before, probably said this before we started the podcast, but... We want to talk about the trailer for this half of the season, because it has a certain Jedi Master. Obi-Wan.
Mm-hmm.
Not like, only that, it has Kanan, which I think this is, I'm the most excited for this, Kanan training Sabine to use the Darksaber.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, you were talking about how people are complaining Sabine is too OP. I think the challenges she's going to face in this season are going to test her, as they're not going to be
absolutely.
Easy.
No,
because
she's going to learn how to sword fight.
Yeah, because she's a great fighter, but this is a completely different kind of fighting than she's used to.
Okay, so we see that she had an energy whip and a shield in her wrist gauntlet, which is two rad things.
Two rad things.
And she has the Darksaber now, and her jetpack
works.
She's
got the Darksaber.
She's the most stacked person in the Ghost Crew.
Yeah. And Kanan's like, you're gonna have to learn to use all of them at once.
Learn.
If you
want.
Yeah.
Because she's good with all of them. For sure.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. But also, there's just saying, like, if you want to champion people behind you, you have it now. So, but you gotta learn how to use it. They were talking about her mother, too. It's like, who is her mother? I want to know who this lady is. I want to meet her, okay? So,
Who is her mother?
I want to know who this mommy is.
Yes.
It's important to me.
We see her. I mean, we have confirmation Sabine has a mom.
A hot second.
Well, I mean, I find the Mandalorian is very interesting. So the more we find out about that, the more I'm like, you know, so I want to know.
Yeah. So.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, well, then also, I mean, you already brought it up, Christina, but we're thinking about, you know, a certain somebody at the end of the trailer, the mid-season trailer. But I was thinking also, like, ultimately, this is going back when they got the answer from the Holocron. That was their answer. That was both their answers.
Yes.
Like,
to two different
Maul's
questions.
For
them. Yeah.
Two different questions, but Maul's looking for him for his own reasons, and they're looking for a way to defeat them Sith, and it's like, oh, wait, and end the war. It's like, that's your answer. So it's like, everybody done looking for Obi-Wan Kenobi. You know, it's like, so.
Yeah.
So, I kind of like that they piped in the original actor's line for the end of the trailer for Obi-Wan.
What line?
When he says, something like, you shouldn't be here, or something like that, that was the original actor whose name escapes me.
From the original trilogy?
from the original Star Wars.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, that kind of piped in that line.
Cool.
Because so, we don't hear him talk. We just hear that line piped in, so I don't know who's doing the voice acting.
Yeah.
For Obi-Wan, when we see him probably murder Maul.
Oh. God willing.
Well, obviously Obi-Wan doesn't die, so
I obviously say, like, we know that much, so yeah. It'll be okay.
Yeah, and
anybody,
we
well, no. Did anybody else notice too? Did I just miss this too? What? Where it's like in the trailer, it's like clearly Alec Guinness's voice. I was like, wait, what? So they like manipulate
Alec Guinness. Oh, yeah, yes, John.
Yeah, John was like, what they did for the Force Awakens. I was like, whoa. He's like, you shouldn't have come here. I was like, what? That's great. I loved it. I was like, that's great. So,
mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I didn't notice that.
That was totally his voice. I was like, ooh.
So.
Yeah.
Besides that, though, we see Thrawn is also jacked.
He's jacked?
Like, no, yeah!
Just fights that battle awesome. For fun.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And then, the TIE Defenders are done. At least one of them's done. So.
Yeah.
They have one TIE Defender.
So yeah, we're definitely going to see the Defenders. And I think my favorite part about that was they kind of mirror what they do in the Rogue One trailer, where the siren was in the background, but they do it with Obi-Wan's voice, which I thought was really interesting and very, very creepy. The whole time I was like, no. Stop.
All right, who's dead? We gotta figure out.
Oh, no!
Long shot. You know who I'm calling?
No.
Sato.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Sato. Yeah.
We're all like, oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's dead. He's dead.
I'm calling Sato dead. I'm calling Callus probably dead.
Oh, Callus, yeah. No.
I like Callus, though, now, so, but he's probably going to go.
And I don't know. Do I have any more people dead?
I feel like a member of the ghost crew has to go to raise the stakes.
Stop.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No.
If it's anyone, it's going to be Kanan.
No!
No. I don't think so.
I'm going to be honest. Kick you out of the podcast.
I don't think it'll be Kanan. I think they're still at a point at which they need it to be somebody not so crucial yet for story purposes. So I say it's going to be Zeb.
I don't know. I mean, it's weird because, like,
no to all of them,
or even Hera. I can't.
Here's the thing.
Hera has plot armor.
Well, no, she can't be dead.
Hera has plot armor. We know she flies the ghost in Rogue One. She has plot armor.
Well, all right. So here's the deal. We have to account for where the ghost people are during the Battle of Yavin, and like the original trilogy. We have to basically account for where they are during the original trilogy. So they have to figure that out.
Yeah.
So, they're obviously, Hera's at least alive in Rogue One, and Chopper is around, too.
But, Hera's not
Hera's not an emotional mess, so Kanan's probably not dead. So, we can assume certain things. Like, they could just be doing other shit while, like, the Battle of Hoth is going on, because, like, I'm sure Chopper Base is still around at that point, and they probably have to defend that from the Imperials as well, so...
But my thought...
There are feasible places for them to be.
Yes. And my thought, which I haven't gone for a second viewing of Rogue One, but we're going to do a podcast on it once I do notes and get organized it and whatever. But what I cannot, in my own memory, recall for the ghost leaving at the end. You know? So
I'm not even confident enough to say that
they make it out of Rogue One. If you know what I mean.
Right. No, they did.
They did. I remember watching that part, too, because I'm going, they're all like, you know what I mean, what part I'm talking about, going, but I couldn't see it, you know?
No, they left.
They did? Okay. See, because I could not remember that.
Cool.
I cannot remember that.
They were one of the first ships to jump to hyperspace.
Either, so I was like,
I couldn't remember that.
Yeah, no, they jumped out.
I was like, eek. The
only ship that didn't make it was that one that crashed into the Star Destroyer. I mean... They all made it. Well, not all, but anything you didn't see blow up didn't blow up. Let's put it that way. So more than likely they're fine. Or whoever is on the ghost at the time is fine. You know, we don't technically know. We know Hera and Chopper.
At least, yeah, exactly, because we see Chopper on the ground.
Physically see Chopper, we hear Hera's name being called.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So, that's it. I mean, now, my one concern is that there is no Mandalorian representative at the council.
Oh.
So, where is Sabine?
Where are the Mandalorians?
Where are the Mandalorians? Yeah, where's Fenn Rao?
Because even if Sabine couldn't be there, Fenn Rao would have been there.
A representative of Mandalore. And I didn't think we saw any Mandalorians floating around.
Wearing armor. I mean, one of them could have been a Mandalore.
Technically. Well, kind of like how Rex was on Endor.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Surprise!
That's Fenn Rao. Whatever.
Sure! He looks enough like Fenn. Fine.
That's him. That's the one.
That's him.
Sabine had normal-ass hair that day, actually. That's her.
that extra that we pulled out of the parking lot for the scene? Yeah, no, that's Fenn Rao.
That's it. Yeah.
I don't know. But for sure, Sato is dead. There's no way he's not dead.
Yeah,
sorry, everybody.
I think we were talking about that when his nephew was in that episode.
And now we know that Thrawn can just squeeze his head because he's so jacked.
Oh my god. I know Kanan lost his sight. And that was pretty shocking, but I don't think anybody's heads are going to go pop in this children's show.
No. Well, I mean, dude, they blew up a guy.
They did. They didn't show it.
Didn't show it, but now he's dead.
He's very dead. Yes.
They're not above killing people.
No, you're right, they're not. But I just mean of what we're going to see and what we won't
see. Oh, yeah, no. But it's, not going to be good.
Yeah.
And I'm throwing this out there. I think there's only going to be one TIE Defender, and it's going to be a prototype. It's going to be the TIE X7 prototype, so it's probably not going to be as good. terrifying as a TIE Defender will be, because they're expensive, and I doubt they're going to be able to make like 30 of them. Maybe a squadron. 1 to 5, I'll say. Yeah, but I don't think we're going to see like forms of TIE Defenders.
Yeah, but I can see there being one and it like doing enough damage for everybody to like piss their pants.
Well, Phoenix Squadron's made out of paper, so they're done. I mean, can see, you know what I can see happening is this being an excuse to bring X-Wings into the show, because an X-Wing could fight a TIE Defender.
Yes. And I mean, you know,
we saw Y-Wings in the trailer.
Still got 2 years to right, because they're going to use those Y-Wings, but we still got 2 years to build up our X-Wings for the Rebels, so.
Oh, they have them already.
Yeah, it's not that we get to see.
No, not in Phoenix Squadron.
Yeah, not in Phoenix Squadron, no. So next episode is called Warhead. Zeb and Chopper bring a damaged droid from the Attilan Wilderness back to base, only to discover the droid is a new Imperial probe programmed to spy on and destroy Rebels. Oops. Oh, we're going to get a Zeb and a Chopper episode. We haven't had one of those in a while.
Thank God.
Yeah.
Been a while.
Because in this episode, actually, Hera's like, Zeb, you're staying on the ship with us. And he's like, what? Why?
Exactly.
I felt that was sort of like a, you know, you haven't been around this season. It's okay, you'll get your turn. But for now, just stay on the ship.
Well.
Stick here.
Yeah.
We haven't seen Zeb opened his staff in like a year.
I know.
Yeah.
Can he like open that baby up and start fighting people again?
Yeah, I want to see that.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a cool gun, but you got a laser staff.
That
man.
Is cooler, and it's like the last of his people. I want to see it.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe Chopper can fight the robot. Because at one point in the trailer, we do see Chopper getting punted by a giant robot, like a giant droid. So maybe this is the episode that happens.
Might be.
He's like.
So that's we'll a fast there, episode.
A dirty fighter.
Yep. Oh, and the trailers are on YouTube for the next episode if everyone wants to watch them. So.
Yes.
Cool. I have to watch the mid-season trailer again because I only saw it the one time and I was like,
me too.
I was like squeaking. I see again.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna have to listen for, shit, I forgot his name again. Alec Guinness.
Line. At the very end, it's very subtle, and I don't know how they did it. Again, same manipulation, I guess, from The Force Awakens. And you know, so when he's like, Rey, you know, same thing, same idea. Mm-hmm. But it sounded a lot like, or if it's not him, they made it sound a lot like him. So James Arnold Taylor has talent for sounding like Ewan McGregor.
Yeah, he really does. But it's uncanny.
So, and I don't know how they did the nonsense. Like, I know about the digital thing for Tarkin. I don't know whose voice that was. That was really good. So,
For sure.
That was very impressive.
Might have been whoever did him on the on the cartoon. Was he? Maybe, no, wait, was he? Yeah, he was.
Tarkin's been in both shows,
That's right! Oh!
Tarkin's been in Clone Wars.
Yeah, remember that episode where he was in the Citadel, which kind of boring, but him and Anakin are all buddy-buddy already. I was like, get out of here!
Oh my god, I love that episode. Okay.
I'm like, anyway.
Sorry.
And he was the one who brought Thrawn on board in the beginning of the season, so.
Yep. Yes, he did. Which I, this is why I love, ultimately, going back to Rogue One, where at the end, like, Tarkin and Vader like to credit. Ha ha! Sorry, man. We're gonna take your thing and take credit for it. Bye-bye.
Oh, yeah.
This is mine now.
Yeah.
No,
I made this.
I don't know why you thought it was yours.
They're like,
fine.
Bye.
This is mine. Because in A New Hope, it's like, no, I made this.
I did this.
Like,
but it was so good because you so expect that. I totally expected that. So I thought it was perfect. I was like, yep, that's about right.
All right.
Okay, last thing. Do you think Thrawn's dead?
Ooh. I don't know.
I feel like that's the only way to stop him.
Right, that's what I thought too. So I was like, oh,
unless you shame him so much that he just curls up into a ball and never comes out.
That shit, guys.
He's Snoke?
There you go. I just figured that out. You're welcome.
All the crazy Snoke
theories. Dude, Snoke is Darth Maul as Boba Fett. Duh.
Duh. And Mace Windu, duh.
And Mace Windu, duh.
All they fused.
No, Snoke is this Yoda taco that I have.
This Yoda taco. Okay, all right, John, where can the people find you? We have to wrap up this podcast.
Okay, you can find me at No More on Twitter.
Sam, where can they find you?
Likely on Twitter and Instagram.
You can find me at Cleomoto, and you can find all of us at ASOTV Podcast on Facebook, Twitter, Gmail, Google+, and right here on YouTube. Follow us for some more podcasts from some of your favorite TV shows, video games, and movies, like Rogue One, which I swear we will do soon. Until next time. Bye, guys.